Hi, Charlie Popeck again with Green Ideas to talk a little bit more about the new LEED V4 program. As promised, we'll now get into more detail about the upcoming changes to LEED that'll be introduced at Green Build in Philadelphia this year. LEED V4 will focus on increasing LEED's technical rigor, expanding the market sectors able to use LEED, and will also strive for simplicity in terms of usability. Generally speaking, as we go through the LEED V4 program, the prerequisites and credits have had their credit language clarified, some credits have been combined, others have added credit requirements or options, some credit requirements have been moved to another credit, some credits have been removed and the options have been distributed among other credits, many credits have had the reference standard updated only, and no substantive changes have been made to many of the credits. So let's get started with the sustainable sites category. Most of the prerequisites and credits have had no substantive changes or only have had the reference standard updated. For instance, the Construction Activity Pollution Prevention Plan prerequisite has had the EPA Construction General Permit updated from the 2003 version to the 2010 version. Several of the credits, like brownfield remediation and light pollution reduction, have had the requirements moved to another credit. Some requirements have been removed and addressed in prerequisites, and others have had the requirements clarified. Okay, within sustainable sites, there's a new credit called Site Assessment, which encourages early analysis of site conditions in order to inform a better design. The Site Development Maximize Open Space credit has been renamed to Open Space and has added the qualification that open space must be of beneficial use to the occupants or the community, and the requirements for turf grass and vegetated roofs have been clarified. The credits previously known as Stormwater Design, Quality Control, and Quantity Control have been combined and renamed Rainwater Management. The goal of this credit is to mimic pre-development hydrology rather than managing off-site water flows, which has been the goal of previous versions of LEED. The Heat Island Effect credits for non-roof and roof surfaces have also been combined and renamed Heat Island Reduction. The SRI requirements have been updated, the paving materials metric has been changed to solar reflectance, and 3-year aged SRI and SR values have been included, along with a weighted SRI average calculation methodology. Within the light pollution reduction credit, the interior lighting requirements have been removed and are now in the energy and atmosphere prerequisite. Additionally, the new bug rating methodology has been introduced as a prescriptive way to meet the exterior lighting requirements. By the way, bug stands for backlight, uplight, and glare, and this methodology will hopefully make the credit easier to achieve. The amount of reflective light off the pavement has also been reduced, and exterior signage requirements have been added. So that's my quick summary of the sustainable sites category for LEED V4. Details about these changes can be found on the USGBC website. Please contact me at charlie@egreenideas.com if you'd like to discuss LEED V4 further or if we can help you out with your project. And once again, please remember that each time a new LEED version has been introduced in the past, the requirements for earning and maintaining LEED accredited professional status changes. So if your goal is to become a LEED Green Associate or LEED AP, take the exam now rather than waiting. It will only get more difficult. Green Ideas can help with one of our best-in-class online LEED exam preparation bundles. Please visit our website at greenideaseducation.com for more information. So we'll see you again next week when we'll be looking into the water efficiency category.